In this video, we will show three options for connecting an Alexa device, such as an Echo Dot or Echo input, so that you can experience Alexa and her streaming audio content through the premium sound of your whole house audio system. The first option provides the best experience, but it is also the most custom and requires that you run a Cat5 or better cable between the location in your home where your equipment is located and a spot in the ceiling of each zone or room in which you plan to install an Alexa device. With this option, you will definitely want to take advantage of one of our amplifiers that includes Auto Detect and Switch, or ADS. An example is the multi-channel amplifier DMA-1240ADS. The ADS feature allows Alexa streaming music and voice responses to override any other audio source currently being listened to. Ask Alexa a question and her response is heard through your speakers. When a response is finished, the amplifier automatically returns to its previous source.
He needs more touches. I know
Alexa, when is the last time the Cowboys won the Super Bowl?
Dallas Cowboys won the Super Bowl in 1996.
Simply install the mounting kit for your Alexa device and use the included hardware to both power the Alexa device and send its audio signal over the single Cat5 cable back to your ADS-enabled amplifier. There, it connects to the voice assistant inputs of the amp channels powering the speakers in that zone. The second option is only available with the Link system. Install either a standard input panel, which connects via Cat5 cable to the Link Touch keypad, or an analog input panel, which connects via Cat5 cable to either a Link Touch or all the way back to the central Link controller. Place the Alexa device in a convenient location within the room, such as on a countertop or nightstand, and connect its audio output to the input panel. To hear Alexa's voice responses and streaming audio content, simply select that source using a Link Touch or the Link app. Note that the Alexa device can be heard in any combination of zones, not just the one in which it is connected. The third option involves using one Alexa device located within a zone to issue a command to a second centrally located Alexa device connected to one of the source inputs on your whole house audio controller. This option is easy to set up, but its functionality is somewhat limited. You'll be able to hear streaming audio from Alexa through your whole house audio speakers, but her responses to questions and commands will only be heard out of the Alexa device located in the zone. To implement this option, simply name the centrally located Alexa device something like main dot. You can then issue a command to the Alexa device located within the zone to play my favorite music on the main dot, or something similar. As long as you have selected the main dot as the source for your zone, you will hear the music stream through your speakers.